The People's House? Welcome to Unfiltered. I'm S.E. Cupp. Did you wake up this morning with an added spring in your step? Did the sun shine a little brighter? Did you breathe a sigh of relief that some of your problems had finally been solved? No? Weird. Because last night, the House of Representatives, the people you elect to govern, write laws, pass budgets, solve problems, did none of those things. Republican lawmakers did, however, stage a very theatrical grievance politics performance meant to satisfy a bloodthirsty base that's seemingly far more interested in revenge than problem-solving or legislating. Republicans along party lines voted to censure former House Intelligence Committee Chairman Adam Schiff, a Democrat from California, for, quote, misleading the American public. 213 Republicans voted for the resolution, while 209 Democrats voted against it. Let's briefly unpack this. Congresswoman Anna Paulina Luna, a Florida MAGA Republican, led the effort with the support of House Speaker Kevin McCarthy to censure Schiff for comments he made several years ago about investigations into former President Donald Trump's ties to Russia. Why? Because they can. And this Republican Party is animated almost exclusively these days by a desire to punish its opponents, even for years-old offenses, even if the effort is purely symbolic. Schiff and Democrats were defiant, with many shouting shame, and Schiff declaring the censure a badge of honor. Now, this is all rich on a number of levels. For one, the party that's found some pearls to clutch over Schiff's old comments is the same party that enabled, protected, and defended Trump's many rhetorical insults, lies, and abuses of power. The party that's now outraged over Schiff's alleged abuse of trust has continued spreading Trump's election lies. The House Speaker, who's appalled by Schiff for, quote, misleading the public, is the same House Speaker who refuses to call on Congressman George Santos to resign despite misleading the public with too many lies to count and being indicted on federal charges, including wire fraud, money laundering, stealing public funds, and yes, lying to Congress, all of which Santos denies. Give me a break. Now, aside from the obvious hypocrisy of this censure from a party that has zero credibility when it comes to truth-telling, accountability, and integrity, there's also just the utter uselessness of it. Like I said, this vote changes nothing, not in the House, not in Washington, and certainly not in your life. So my question to you is, do you feel better about inflation this morning? More optimistic about an end to the war in Ukraine? What about the opioid crisis or crime in your city or town? Are you less worried today about gun violence? Because that censure, that symbolic performance, that useless waste of time and energy was your taxpayer dollars hard at work. You should at least get something out of it. Okay, that's it for me. See you next week.